I'm going to start play as soon as
On three or after three? I feel like we're doing the bit from Lethal Weapon or something.
How appropriate! So, welcome to this Let's Play of True Crime New York City.
Hello, I'm...
Drunk?
No, I was just gonna say I'm TBZ, but people might hear that if they watch our other LPs.
New York City, Manhattan Island, 25 square miles of crowds, concrete, crime so cold they'd wither the soul and freeze the blood. Millions exist here, walking streets that may swallow them whole or spit out their bones. Locked away for the better part of 15 years, you've got no choice but to rely on those closest to you to watch out for your interests outside. In my absence, my son was given the keys to my kingdom, placing his trust in those who claimed my allegiance. As it turned out, it was a decision both of us would come to regret. And on the streets of New York City, regrets are measured in bullets.
No, man! I swear!
Get the fuck out.
Now.
Now, why you cheating? Give me some audible, dog.
Fuck you, nigga. You need to get up on it.
But y'all niggas need to shut the fuck up. Marcus!
Damn, dude. Look who ain't dead, yo!
I ain't the only one.
What you talking about, nigga?
Your boy's fucked up, Kev. My pops is still alive.
It was so important they had to pause the game.
Well, yeah, time's gonna run out.
So before you actually become a cop, you have this prologue where you're actually a gangbanger.
Get in there, cop Marcus, you idiots!
I'm gonna say, because, you know, besides Max Payne, I don't think many cops do this kind of stuff.
You fucking...
Kinda unbecoming for a police officer.
Much.
A bit, yeah.
You're heading this way. Be on point!
So, like most tutorials, controls are disabled until you actually run into the situation where it tells you how to use them.
So you can't crouch until it tells you how?
Nope.
That's stupid. It's always stupid.
I think this is it for me.
Getting old enough to not feature a cover system.
You want shit till I brought you in.
You just like your old man. You always go get played, nigga.
What the hell happened, Marcus?
They tried to murk me too. Motherfuckers with no loyalty don't deserve to live.
Jesus Christ.
I guess you gotta do what you gotta do.
Okay. Okay, I'll take care of it.
Don't owe me nothing.
Marcus, I helped raise you, and this is not how I expect to be repaid. Look, you can't keep doing this. You've had some scratches before, but this one, we're talking about one big fucking band-aid. It's the last time I'm saving your ass, so you better do exactly as I say, or you're on your own forever.
All right, man.
Now get the fuck out of here, kid. Merry Christmas.
Into the organized crime.
You know, I remember when you couldn't even wipe your own ass without my help, hotshot. So don't get cocky. You ain't a detective yet.
Come on. You know I'm going to blaze through those qualification tests like that.
Oh, you in that much of a hurry to get out of my unit?
Lieutenant Dixon, nah, I was just...
Save it. I'm happy for you. You're going to make a hell of a detective.
Well, hurry up and polish your badge or you're going to be late.
What's this? Gangsters dressed as cops, huh? It ain't Halloween, Terry.
We talked about this, Victor. My contract, remember?
Goddamn, Terry. You know I don't like greenhorns in my...
Marcus has been on a beat for 4 years now. Just aced all the CIC stuff.
Yeah. Told them. Remember, it's your responsibility. Comprende?
You got it, Vic. This is it, kid. All you gotta do is pass, huh? Don't shoot yourself in the foot, huh?
You know, you'd think they'd screen people to not let known gangbangers into the police force.
Well, the implication is that Mickey Rourke sponsors you in, I guess.
Or maybe he made sure to keep you out of any records.
I mean, it's kind of hard to hide that you killed 30 people in one night.
Well, isn't that the implication of him saying, I'll take care of it? But on the other hand, your dad is a known criminal who's in jail, like a major gang boss.
So for the default controls, you have to use the number pad for hand-to-hand combat. You could try changing them, but you can't actually change the controls unless you run this game on Windows XP. And from my experience, when you change them, if you have to run the game again after quitting, they'll reset themselves, so you have to reset them all over again.
But can't you set, like, a config file to read-only or something?
I've tried looking, there's no config file, there's like... I think it modifies the EXE directly or something, I don't know how it works.
Time to move without being seen. I want you to sneak up on this guy. Crouch to move.
I mean, for the purposes of this tutorial, we're not gonna actually kill anybody. But that is something you can do later on.
We're just gonna stand here while you choke your buddy.
Reminds me of those Chuck Norris movies where they just line up one by one to get beaten up by him.
Well, that's basically every kung fu movie ever.
Yeah, but his are just really bad.
Kick them while they're down.
Hey man, if I don't do this fast enough, I might not pass the test.
Oh no.
Man down! Man down!
Pretty sure that's police brutality.
Very nice results, sir.
So you can play like good cop or bad cop?
Yep.
And you're going to do which one?
Well, it doesn't really change that much in the actual game. I'll probably leave it up to the thread vote, because you can You can change it right before you finish the game. That's the only time where it matters, is the end of the game.
Oh, it has cover.
It's really cumbersome, and I almost never use it.
It's badly controlled.
Yeah, and you can't manually aim. Not that the manual aim is any good.
Ready to get flashy? Let's see if you can dive.
Bullet time dives are also really bad.
I expect great things from this LP. Whoa. Just like some fucking crazy grenades. I can almost smell the napalm. So the announcer likes explosions way too much.
He's basically the drill sergeant from Full Metal Jacket.
Now look around and find your target. Nice and easy. Now locate the non-lethal area and fire away. We call it neutralizing shots.
So if you want to play good cop, the easiest way to get extra good points is if you decide to shoot people in their blue zones. That'll earn you extra good cop points, but it's not necessary.
So it's not a killing shot?
Well, unless they have really low health, then they're gonna die anyway, I think. Like, once we start doing the street test, they'll elaborate more on how things will actually work outside of the obstacle course.
You shot a civilian.
Oh, it's fine.
You're already a bad cop.
I only shot one civilian, so I still pass.
So, the bad cop, good cop thing is kind of like Deus Ex, where nothing really matters until the very end.
Well, it also changes your player character dialogue on the fly, I believe.
Oh, that's kind of neat.
But yeah, it doesn't have any relevance to the actual story until the very, very end. It's also actually really easy to become a bad cop, because running over civilians will give you, like, a lot of bad cop points. And because the civilian AI is so terrible, like, if you accidentally, like, run up on a curve, you'll, like, pancake 5 civilians. And that'll just run up your bad cop meter so much.
Well, they obviously didn't learn from Midtown Madness.
Weren't civilians invincible in that game?
Yeah, they would just dive the fuck out of the way really fast.
It was a fun game, though.
Yeah.
Watch out for the people now! Don't you hit any! Smooth driving, schoolboy! Guess what, rookie? You're done. Exit the vehicle and head for the door. Congratulations, officer! This completes your CIC qualifications test.
And it didn't count your second pit maneuver.
Because he's a jerk.
No, honey, the lockers at Grand Central. No, the new ones. Yeah, suits him there. Está ahí el traje. No te apure. All right, you know what? No problem. Okay, love you too.
Why don't you just move into the city, Vic? Yeah, save yourself a train ride.
And my salary. So you're kidding, right?
Looks like you still have both feet, kid. Was I fucking right about this guy or what? Denzel ain't got nothing on you, kid.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, Terry, how hard is it to shoot a target? I want you to take him into the street, see if he can handle himself in plain clothes and deal with real perps. Do the whole drill. Otherwise, no shield. Comprende?
Okay, boy wonder. Time to kiss your costume goodbye. Grab your street gear.
Then pick up an unmarked cruiser at the garage. I'll meet you outside.
Yo, I got your boy Wonder right here.
Gonna hit streets?
Yep. You can wander around the police stations. Well, so far we only have the garage level.
Does it have anything interesting later on?
Yeah, there's a shooting range you can't use, but that's where you can go buy, like, your weapon upgrades and stuff. Your garage is where you can buy car upgrades.
Are they essential to the playing the game?
Maybe for 100% completion, but
hey, detective,
for the main story, they're not necessary. Main okay, story is easy enough, right really.
Hey, Terry! ¿Que no te gusta la comida de mi mujer?
Para decirte la verdad, Manny. No, but we'll talk later. All right, kid, let's cruise. Talked to your father lately?
Nah, man.
I saw him a couple of weeks back. He wanted to see you.
Yeah. Well, Pop can call me if he wants to. Besides, he ain't the one out here watching my back.
Ah, come on, Marcus. We're practically family, right?
Right.
All right, now let me see you drive, huh? Here, check your GPS. You think you can beat the clock? Then step on it.
Man, I gotta hurry up.
You want to get through traffic? How about using that siren, huh?
Hey!
See this? Besides the flickering and the light?
And the fog? And the low draw distance?
I'm not saying what I did was alright.
You just ruined everything.
Boy Scout, you're making good time.
Just look that bad.
Well, I know. I thought it looked pretty good back in 2005.
Okay, you made it. Just pull up, get out of the car.
Oh, come on, Terry. Don't make me jump through these hoops.
Just go through the motions, kid. Keeps Navarro off our backs, right?
Yeah, okay.
Keep your phone on. I'll run you through a few basics. Well, what the hell are you waiting for? Get the hell out of the car.
All right, let's see your frisking hunches. Pick three males and pat them down for contraband.
So this will run us through the basics of solving crimes in free roam.
Hit up three random guys.
It's completely scripted, so it's always the last guy who has drugs.
Hey, asshole! Cut me some slack. Will this change your mind?
You can accept bribes, but you can't do that during this tutorial.
Walk over to the parked car over there and pop its trunk for me, would you?
Police! Pop your trunk!
Hey, looks like you found something. You know I heard some cops sell the stuff at the pawn shops. But you're gonna voucher it at the precinct, right? Whoa, look at these guys. We got a few hard cases. Well, you should already know there are different types of perps. There are the unarmed types. Shooting these guys is a definite no-no. Then there are the perps armed with a bat or a knife or something. Save your bullets unless absolutely necessary. Or my favorite, the jokers that are back in heat. It's open season on them. Whoa, what's going on over there? Looks like we got a bar problem. I want you to crash the party.
So you can flash your badge or fire a warning shot to get these people to try to cooperate.
When the badge doesn't do the trick, you gotta pump some ear.
I'm guessing the pistol is more effective.
Almost always, yes.
No. Look at that. Nice shooting. Now put some cuffs on those pricks before they run for it.
Yo, maybe you'll wise up after this.
And again, the last guy you handcuff is always the guy who runs away, and he always runs faster than normal to get away from you.
Do you have to keep running or get a car?
You have to get a car. It's scripted. You can't use your own car.
Hey Marcus, are you
fantastic.
One of your
well, I'm trying to shoot the car right now so it stops, but you can't.
Fuck you, shit!
This guy's the worst driver.
Look at this loser. He may be useful. Don't kill him, hotshot.
Nick O'Rourke agrees.
All right, look, ditch your car, chase him down on foot.
One thing to notice is that this particular suspect has a triangle over his head. In the main game, that usually means that he's important and you should not kill him if you want to finish the mission.
I'll say really, character really looks like Snoop Dogg.
Well, he was a playable character in the first game.
Reusing models, aw yee. A plus. Now, let's go see the king.
That will be all, Kurt. You've been looking after my boy, Terry?
I've been looking after myself, Pop.
How you been, Isaiah?
Just doing my time. To what do I owe the honor?
Thought you might want to see this.
Uh-huh. Seems my boy is no longer just a pawn. Congratulations, son. Life's full of irony, isn't it?
Higgins. Okay, I'll be there. Well, Isaiah, we gotta cut this short.
I'll be seeing you. Kurt, let him out.
You did good, Boy Scout. You know, you're the first new face in OCU in 7 years.
Yeah. Seems like Navarro keeps that unit pretty tight.
There's a reason for that. We'll talk about it. Some other time, though. Drive me to Mulberry and Spring. We got no time to lose.
Shit, where's the fire, man?
Come on, Marcus. This is important. Get your ass in the car.
Why do we keep playing games with famous voice actors making voices for them?
Well, obviously they had to take the budget away from the gameplay department.
They have the real important stuff, you know, expensive actors.
And Mickey Rourke shows up for like a grand total of 20 minutes in this game. I'm sure that was money very well spent.
I'm sure Mickey Rourke got his money's worth from...
this?
Rogue
Warrior?
Yeah. I've got the name. I should have stolen that game again. Get the last achievements.
Can you tell me what's up with that briefcase?
Sure, if you need to know.
Nah, man, it's cool.
If I'm not out in 6 minutes, you come in guns blazing.
Alright, I got your back.
Somebody talk to me.
No, man.
What the hell were you two doing?
Hey, man, I don't know shit. Terry went inside.
Get him the fuck out of here.
You feeling better?
Not really.
I'm sorry, Marcus.
Yeah, me too.
It wasn't your fault. Forensics says it was a gas leak.
Bullshit.
Look, I know that you and Terry were close, Marcus, but you need to let this go. It's Navarro's business now. He's not gonna let you touch it.
No more OCU, huh?
Maybe one day, but for now, you're back here with me, working street crime.
I'm not putting those blues back on.
Relax, it's plainclothes duty. You get to keep your shield, as long as you play nice.
Fuck that. I need to find out what really happened.
Marcus, I'm trying to help you here. Crime has been on the rise all over the city, so please, do me a favor. Get out there and collar me some perps, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So, let's go get chewed out by our superiors.
Marcus, listen, I just wanted to say it's good to have you back in street crime. Really.
Well, yeah, I think that's, you know, mandatory in games like this.
It's kind of part of the genre.
Yo, loose cannon!
Goddamn, Reed. Terry was the best detective I had. But you didn't know that, did you?
That was kind of lame.
detective. What can I do for you?
In the next video, we'll be hitting the streets.